Never! Nakinontak ako. I'm working in Congress 4 times a week, Monday to Thursday. Our office is open in here, daily. I have an office in my district. 7 punctuality, bilyonaryo.com. And even the owner, si Gil Kabakungan, kilala kita, kilala mo ako. It's either you were used by these extortionists or you were used by other people who are connected. Ang sinasabi ninyo kasi sa media, sinasabi nila, mga nigas kugon lang yung mga congressman. After that, wala na rin mangyayari. Ang sinasabi nila, yung mga congressman na yan, nagpapataas lang yung mga presyo yung mga yan. But it's better that we are fighting than not. This is the blacklist era na kung saan palasak ang ginagawa sa cargo airlines. This is a legitimate business that we are into right now. 10% lamang yung aking pong biniling share dito. Pero mukha ko ang inilabas nila. Ha? And according to bilyonaryo.com, trending pa sila.
All invited resource persons, thank you. And raise your right hand. Do you solemnly swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth in this inquiry? I do. Thank you, sir. And ma'am, please take your seat.
Baka mga 3 days or 5 days ago lamang ito nangyari. Alam nyo, I just wanted to share yung sinulat ng bilyonaryo.com na kung saan sinimulan yung paninira sa akin, na kung saan binabanggit nila dito yung isang bagay tungkol doon sa maliit na bahagi ko dito sa cargo airlines na to na almost 10% lamang. Pero mas pinaniwalaan nila, no, yung issue noong mga extortionist na ang trabaho nila is to attack and collect. This is the blacklist era na kung saan palasak ang ginagawa sa cargo airlines. This is a legitimate business that we are into right now. 10% lamang yung aking pong biniling share dito. Pero mukha ko ang inilabas nila. Ha? And according to bilyonaryo.com, trending pa sila. Ang ginamit nilang issue ay itong mga may-ari na mga Ukrainian people na ang kanilang layunin ay wasakin ang mga kumpanya dahil sila po ang mga nagmi-middle, nag-aahente sa dalawang nagkakaroon ng problema. And to all the victims, no? Na biktima ng mga ito. Ito po ang sinasabi. This is the effective method used by blacklist aero is a whole complex of illegal techniques, the purpose of which is moral and psychological pressure on companies. First, this is information pressure with threats of damage of reputation. This includes posting false and fake information on the internet or social media. In legal terms, this is called defamation and blackmail. After this, extortion of money and the use of criminal methods of debt collection from into. This is where threats, constant phone calls and emails to managers and employees, psychological pressure and false presentation of themselves as lawyers or even higher ranking officials come into force. Ganito po ang ginawa sa amin last year. Ang ginawa po nila, lahat halos ng mga congressman dito, pinadala nila ng email. Lahat ng mga senador, pinadala nila ng email. No? At nung hindi naging effective, ang kinontak po nila ay mga media. Hindi po nila lahat ng media. But this bilyonaryo.com, I invited them over. Si Melanie Menchas, who wrote this article and saying, dito sa kanyang sinulat, attempt by bilyonaryo.com to contact Fernandez for comments led to a recommendation to send an email. However, an email sent to the provided address was returned and delivered the following day. Never nakinontak ako. I'm working in Congress 4 times a week, Monday to Thursday. Our office is open in here daily. I have an office in my district 7 times a week. Pero alleging, dito po, na kinontak niyo ako, never niyo akong kinontak. Where is your factuality? Billionario.com. And even the owner, si Hil Kabakungan, kilala kita, kilala mo ako. It's either you were used by these extortionists or you were used by other people who are connected with illegal gambling. Which is which? You can never stop us. To all those media, no? Napayola kayo ng mga illegal gambling. You can never stop us. We will continue to fight. It's better to fight and lose than never fight at all. Ang sinasabi ninyo kasi, sa media, sinasabi nila, mga nigas kugon lang yung mga congressman. After that, wala na rin mangyayari. It's better to fight in pew than not at all. Ang tagal na ng problema ng illegal gambling, years and decades ago, problema na natin to. Pero meron pa rin mga nakikipaglaban dito. Ang sinasabi nila, yung mga congressman na yan, nagpapataas lang yung mga presyo yung mga yan. But it's better that we are fighting than not at none at all. What we are trying to say, even our ancestors, yung mga nakipaglaban sa mga Espanyol, 333 years bago nila nakuha kanilang freedom. Even, mga no, nakipaglaban tayo sa mga Hapon, nakipaglaban tayo sa mga Amerikano, it's not an easy fight. Even the illegal gambling is not an easy fight. And you cannot even accuse us. Shame on you who are accusing us that we are just using this committee to gain something. If one or several congressmen who are here to fight and gain something, shame on them. But if one of us or all among us is fighting to eradicate illegal gambling, salute to all of us. Sana, mag-ingat naman po mga media. Huwag naman po ganyan. You join us in this fight. And don't judge the feelings and the hearts and the minds of our members in this committee. Because we are fighting for the moral values of our community and the future of our children. Kung atin pong nangyayaring mga sugala na illegal, okay na yung legal eh. Huwag nyo nang gawing illegal. This is a lonely battle. This is a lonely battle. Ang kalaban namin andun, maraming pera. We will never stop. We will never stop. Ay, salamat po. Pasensya po mga kasama. We will be proceeding to the those personalities that we have invited. Comsec, can you kindly tell us kung sino yung mga invited na hindi nakarating? Can you give me the documents? So we have invited the PCSO and we have received several letters telling us that they cannot appear on this hearing. And unfortunately, this is a very important meeting that we have to discuss and the head of the agency must be present. So I hope Congressman Paduana.
Thank you, Chair.
Anyway, if you want to say something, mga members who are here. Sige.
Anyway, thank you. Thank you very much, Chairman Dan. Good morning to everyone, especially to the reserve speakers and to the members of this honorable committee. Mr. Chairman, we have a letter coming from GM Robles. And as far as I remember, he was invited during the first hearing of this investigation. And he was also absent during the time. And the excuse made through this letter is that J.M. Robles has prior commitments, which was not stated. And in his letter for on behalf of J.M. Robles...
Are you putting that into motion?
Yeah. That's
okay,
why,
go ahead.
That's why my motion is to issue a subpoena.
To but there's a motion to issue subpoena to...
subpoena, add testificandum to Janet De Leon Mercado.
To Jerry?
Janet.
Janet Mercado. Second motion. Any second motion?
Second motion.
There's a second motion. Any objection? Hearing none, the said motion is now approved.
by the good congressman from
Colada.
Ambisawa.
Yeah.
Ambisawa party list. Now, Mr. Chairman, the motion that was stated by the good congressman from Antipolo, Congressman Chairman Ako, was for the GM. Sabotay ng anong .com. Anyway, gentlemen, I think the motion that was made by Chairman Ako was still, he moved to for the GM to explain on the next hearing. But for me, it's also a Siokos order. It's for the GM to explain why he should be cited in contempt for not attending two invitations in this hearing. Now, unless the good congressman from Ambisawa will have another motion or amendment to the motion that was raised by Congressman Akop, I think the chair in this committee will be open enough to entertain and to study that particular motion that will be raised by the good congressman.
Is it a manifestation or you wanted to amend the,
the motion that was... The judgment of the chairman of this committee.
Okay, all right. So we will maintaining the motion by Congressman Akop. But before we proceed, the chair would like to recognize Congressman Akop.